Well, and welcome. In this video, we want to look at the difference between fast research and deep research in terms of giving you sources for your purpose in NotebookLM. First, when you open a new notebook and you come to the Add Sources area, you can click on Discover Sources. It's going to take you to this element inside of your NotebookLM. You're going to see two areas, a drop-down menu for fast research and a drop-down menu for deep research. And you can see here that fast research is considered to be great for quick results, deep research, in-depth report, and results. So if we start with fast research and we have a topic, and everything is going to depend on what your purpose is for the topic. But if you were to start with a specific topic, you can write a topic in. Of course, when you use fast research, you can research either the documents in your drive or the web. In most cases, you're going to use the web. We're now going to click submit, and you're going to see here that NotebookLM is researching websites. You will see that the research is going to be completed very quickly. The process from this point works the same. You're going to go to the View tab, and you're going to choose the sources that you want to use for your own purposes. The deep research process is going to be different. We're going to turn on deep research. We're going to ask the very same question. So in this case, we're going to perform a similar search, except we're going to use deep research. We're going to ask for NotebookLM to go through the process. So in this case, we're going to mark time. I'm going to stop the video here. We're going to pick it up from the completion of this process, and we'll know how long the deep research process for this question is going to take, even though every question is going to be different in terms of the way you ask it and what NotebookLM is able to do. Process in NotebookLM is complete. So you have basically two elements that you can either import or decide that you want. First, you're going to have a summary report. That's going to be at the very top. If you scroll through that report, you can scroll all the way to the bottom of the report. You'll then have the sources that are cited. So you're going to have the sources that are cited and as well as the sources that are not cited. You can choose to bring those sources into your notebook or you can leave them out. Depending on my purpose, I could just bring the summary in. Maybe the only thing that I really want was a summary that I'm going to be using over in the studio, and I'll just import the summary report into my area here. So one thing you can try is you can ask the AI to copy the entirety of the report into the chat area so that you can save it as a note. Now, this is not a word-for-word rendering of the report. We can then save this as a note, though. Apparently, you can copy the entire report and you can cut and paste it into your favorite word processing software. And finally, there is no history here for the prompt that you use. So you're going to want to make sure that you write those prompts in a note here inside this area before you enter them into the fast research or the deep research area inside of NotebookLM. And this will give you a record of your prompts, and you'll want to date them again based on the fact that there's no date order of the information inside of NotebookLM. We've seen some basics on how to use deep research and how to use fast research inside of NotebookLM. Okay, so thanks, and I will see you in another video.